Welcome to the paper presentation session today, 6 September at Osmocon 2014, powered by NECC and Safola Oats. We welcome you all. The guidelines for the session, each presenter will have a total time of 9 minutes. After 6 minutes, we'll give you a warning bell. After 7 minutes, we'll give you the ending bell. And if you continue your presentation beyond the 7 minutes, you'll be given negative marks. So please stick to the time. And
our first presenter is Sudhi Shankar Mani from Usmania Medical College.
Good morning, everyone. I am Sudhir Shankar Mane, MBBS third year student from Osmania Medical College. I am here to present my paper title, Infant and Young Child Feeding Practices Among Mothers in Urban Andhra Pradesh, Debunking the Myths. The introduction. We all know that malnutrition is a major problem encountered in public health. Almost a majority of the children in India are malnourished, and a significant proportion of these can be linked to poor IYCF practices. IYCF stands for infant and young child feeding practices. So it has been shown in many studies that optimal IYCF practices go a long way in preventing malnutrition. According to a study in Lancet Journal, it has been proved that exclusive breastfeeding up to 6 months and breastfeeding up to 12 months is the leading intervention that can help prevent under 5 mortality. And in the next slide, you can see that initiation of breastfeeding after 1 hour progresses, the odds of a child catching an infection and subsequent mortality are much higher. The state of IYCF practices in India. We have compared NFHS 2, that is National Family Health Survey 2, 3, and District Level Health Survey 3. So over the years, you can see that the indicators have been better, but when it comes to complementary feeding, that is starting solid and semi-solid foods after 6 months, is quite poor in the last DLHS 3. Optimal IYCF practices include initiation of breastfeeding within one hour of birth, and then exclusive breastfeeding for 6 months, giving colostrum, and beginning complementary feeding at 6 months of age, along with breastfeeding up to at least 2 years of age. So the reasons for the current study, there are a lot of studies that have already been published related to IYCF practices in India. Every region has its own IYCF practices, but then we plan to do the study because the WHO has incorporated new guidelines for assessment of IYCF practices in 2008, and we have also tried to incorporate how the different reasons for not practicing the ideal. We have tried to incorporate the reasons that the mothers gave for not following the ideal IYCF practices. We have tried to present them as a pie chart, wherein the most common reason and the subsequent way of tackling it. So, moving on, the primary objective was to assess the population using 8 core indicators and 7 optional indicators prescribed by the WHO, and the secondary objective was to assess the causes for inadequate IYCF practices, materials and methods. The cross-sectional study was conducted at the immunization OP at Nilofer Hospital in Hyderabad, and the subjects were mothers of children aged 0 months to 24 months who were attending the immunization OP. The inclusion criteria, all mothers of children aged from 0 months to 24 months. We excluded mothers of children who had congenital birth defects like cleft palate, cleft lip, and also mothers of adopted children. the sample size. The sample size was calculated using the indicator initiation of breastfeeding. In the latest NFHS, initiation of breastfeeding had the least prevalence of around 25%. So based on this, a sample size of 289 was calculated, but we went ahead and extended our sample size to 500. And institutional ethical committee clearance was taken before beginning the study. Data collection, a pre-tested questionnaire was administered to the mothers, and they were asked several questions related to IYCF practices, a sample of which is on the next slide. The 8 IYCF indicators proposed by the WHO are early initiation of breastfeeding, exclusive breastfeeding under 6 months, continued breastfeeding at 1 year, introduction of solid, semi-solid or soft foods, minimum dietary diversity, minimum meal frequency, minimal acceptable diet, and consumption of iron-rich foods. The optional indicators include ever breastfed, continuing breastfeeding at 2 years, age-appropriate breastfeeding, predominant breastfeeding under 6 months, duration of breastfeeding, bottle feeding, and milk feeding frequency for non-breastfed children. Knowledge about practices and reasons for inadequate practices were also collected. The sample questionnaire, this is the first question in the questionnaire, and there are subsequently 11 questions which assess all the IYCF indicators. So you can see here that we've asked the mother if she is ever breastfed her child. If no, what the reason was. If she is breastfed the child, we asked her how long after birth did she breastfeed the child. And if she hasn't, what the reason was. So every indicator, we followed it up with subsequent questions to try to get the reasons. The reasons for not following the adequate IYCF practice. Statistical analysis, the data was collected electronically and on paper. Electronically, it was done using Google Forms. And the results, the core indicators, almost 54% of the mothers did not breastfeed after birth. And the most common reason that they provided was cesarean section. Colostrum, 78.87% of the mothers gave colostrum to the child, and others discarded them because they thought it was spoilt milk or it was bad for the baby, or they were asked to do so by the elderly people in the house. Exclusive breastfeeding, almost 80% of the mothers exclusively breastfed their children for first 6 months. Among those who didn't, 47% of them knew that they had to breastfeed, but then they provided various reasons for not doing so. They said that the baby was not drinking milk, or they said milk was not sufficient. They ended up in lactation failure, or they said that there was discomfort in the breast. The other minor indicators include currently breastfed 86.8%. And introduction of complementary feeding is 72.5%. We also compared our findings with the NFHS, and we found that our results were comparatively better when compared to NFHS. But then there still existed a knowledge gap. Between the ideal practices and what was being followed in the community. So we suggest that there should be healthcare workers should be incorporated, nurses, Anganwadi workers, A&Ms, all of them should be trained so that the mothers, when they visit the healthcare facility, they are educated about the optimal IYCF practices. And the limitations of our study. Okay, thank you.
With this is, if this is a hospital-based study.
Yes, ma'am.
And you are comparing with NFHS.
Yes, ma'am.
NFHS is a community-based study.
Community-based study.
And you cannot compare a hospital-based data with a community-based data. Sir. One thing, practices.
Yes, ma'am. Most of the mothers said that they got the knowledge from the Anganwadi workers in their they had come to Nilofer Hospital only for getting vaccines. certain vaccines were not available in their local Anganwadi centers, which is why they were referred to the immunization clinic at Nilofer Hospital, which is why we thought it would be appropriate to compare them with NFHS. And they said that their major source of information was the ANMs, the Anganwadi workers, and then ads on television, and also some of the mothers were educated enough to find out about IVCF practices.
Okay. Good. No, one more thing is related to the demographic profile of your participants.
Yes,
you should have given that information so that from where they got this information, that will be easy for you to analyze that. No?
Yes, ma'am.
Good.
So another thing is, advice from the antenatal period.
Yes.
That is very, very important, you know, like, because that is not the time, at the time of the birth, if you tell them also, they won't listen to us.
Yes.
So the best period is antenatal period, and then telling the, and also about the, and their when the work status. So many of the educated people, and then though they are educated, they know about the breastfeeding because of the going back to the work and all that.
Yes.
Most of the time,
in fact,
they
that
may
was a major reason.
That
why
was the major. That is a major issue actually among the, because even in the low literacy people, many of them they go back to their work.
Ma'am.
So that could have been added. That what is the factors which are hampering the breastfeeding.
Thank you.
Okay. It's nice presentation.
Thank you.